the world of the ASEAN Economic Community. So I informed my colleagues in MITI that we better tell the world that we now living in a different world. We are in a smaller village. We are united as a community. But unfortunately, for whatever reason, the beginning of 2016 did not quite signify much in terms of the setting up the ASEAN Economic Community. So going forward, we would like to achieve even closer economic integration in 2016 and beyond. And 2020, we've got another important milestone to achieve in terms of ASEAN economic integration. And we hope to be able to increase intra-ASEAN trade, intra-ASEAN investment. And I would like to see more exports to other ASEAN countries. But before we increase exports, of course, we need to increase the sales of electric scooters in the Malaysian market. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's all I have this afternoon. I'm here to provide moral support and encouragement to this project. Firstly, it is in line with our vision to make Malaysia the hub for the manufacture and assembly of energy efficient vehicles. Secondly, we have stated our objective of reducing carbon emission to fulfill our obligation to reduce carbon emission globally. And this project, of course, will result in a reduction, substantial reduction. I mean, by definition, electric means there's no smoke, there's no emission at all. So this is a project which is strongly encouraged by the government of Malaysia, and we hope penetrate the emission market. At present, it's only 500 out of 500,000. Yeah, how much is that? 0.0001%. Yeah? So we've got a long way to go. Yeah? So good luck, and I can assure you that the government will continue to support this very important industry. It had its beginnings in Malaysia, and we'll also want to take and others work with you in order to sell in other ASEAN markets. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for giving me this opportunity. Good luck to Dato' Ganesh and your team. How many of you are from what's the name of your company? Eklemo? How many of you are from Eklemo? How many do you employ? 20. Okay, so you produce about how many per week? About 4 or 5 scooters a week, eh? Unless some of you want to buy. How many want to buy this scooter? no on the spot sale.
Okay.
Yeah, for me in particular. Between Matre and MITI building. Okay, so I would like to welcome a friend, Mr. Muzin Al-Kazawi. Had the pleasure of visiting his family home in Jeddah in November. Eh? Rina and his family home. I hope your visit and your presence here will promote closer ties between Malaysia and Saudi Arabia. So thank you very much. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
It is the launching of the Eklemo rental application.
This is if you see our battery, our battery after 3 years, we can actually change the cell. Then we can actually recycle it.
And now I would like to invite Dr. Denis Chua to present a doctor of attention to our YB minister. And also
and
Dr.
Denis Chua, you can charge your phone. You can also switch on your lights. Okay, recharge it, normal commissioner, or one piece of solar panel.
Malaysia Eklemo
500 skuter tiga di Cambodia, kecewa lah kerana potensi cukup besar semua dengan elektrik. Mereka ni isu utama ialah kos ya. Kosnya cukup tinggi, 3-4 kali ganda lebih tinggi daripada kos vehicle konvensional, kerana separuh daripada kos skuter merupakan kos bateri. Yang pertama bateri ni berat, yang kedua ni kosnya ya, half the price of the scooter comes from the cost of producing the batteries ya. Jadi ini merupakan mungkin halangan utama lah. Maksudnya kalau ada teknologi baru yang dapat menurunkan kos bateri dengan mendadak, it will provide a direct competition, it will post direct competition to conventional motorcycles ya. Sekarang ini kita keluar kira-kira 660,000 motorcycles per annum di Malaysia, 660,000 ya. Honda, Yamaha, ya, SYM and others. Jadi this is 500 ya. I mean the content 500 and 660,000, this is small, small, very small percentage. Jadi potential huge provided the company can reduce the cost of production. Jadi one of these scooters, you can buy 3 motor, conventional motorcycle. That's the biggest challenge. Jadi that's for the entrepreneur to come up with improvements and technology which will result in a substantial reduction in cost. The same is true with electric vehicles. We talk about Nissan Leaf or Musk, apa dia panggil, Tesla for example. Mr. Musk has produced the Tesla for example. I mean, this is a big obstacle. Otherwise, it is pollution free. I mean, there's so many advantages of electric vehicles. But the biggest problem is the cost of production. So the challenge is for scientists and innovators to come up with solutions to reduce the cost of production. And if that happens, this has got quite very bright potential. Of course, the government through KETA and MIDA and MEI will be working closely with the company to ensure that this product can sell better in Malaysia and outside Malaysia. And that will, in my view, happen when the company can reduce cost of production substantially. Okay, terima kasih. Saya ada ucapan berbaca tu. Dan lain-lain, Datuk akan kita. Okay, boleh.
So you have successfully entered the Cambodia market. So what's next? Maybe you are currently eyeing.
We are very much focused into Cambodia first. Why? Because it's a heritage site whereby the current taxi in Angkor Wat alone is 10,000 units. So we have to come up with a strategy.
That many?
Yeah, they have 10,000 units of taxi.
When I was there, I only saw 100.
10,000. Because of Angkor Wat, like last year, the tourists have increased to about 4 million tourists. So there are 10,000 potential.
The potential is huge. You have 3, yeah? Right. Yeah, and there's 10,000 and there's only 3 of these scooters.
So why we until today we have 3 is also because of this heritage site is supported by Japan Environment Ministry to test our technologies in Angkor Wat. So far we are the only one who managed to survive until today. The vehicles there is already reached like 12,000 kilometers. So the Japanese, why they involved is because they also part of the contributors of funds to acquire the scooters and put it into Angkor Wat. So they emphasize on why we don't sell it today is because of the cost. The cost is still high and the battery cost is about 50%. So how we actually able to penetrate the market right now, especially with our major clients KFC, we actually lease it to them right now. We don't sell the bike, we lease it to them.
KFC and all
KFC,
the police.
Police and city
council. Okay, we launched the app. That's going to be in Penang. Yeah. You want to rent one of these scooters? Yeah, you go to the app and you can rent. Hourly, yeah?
Hourly, okay. Yes. You can actually subscribe
to that's the model. Yeah. Kalau beli mungkin mahal lah. Tak mampu lah. Kalau beli kereta.
So any plans to sell it?
The plan planning of selling it at this moment, we have yet to plan it out. We will still continue with our leasing model with government agencies or GLCs. So especially on the municipal council.
Yeah, because the tempatan, DBT.
Yeah, because they have their enforcement officer patrolling the roads.
So for Cambodia, do you sell it or you just also leave?
Okay, for the Cambodia, is selling it, whereby the when I mentioned the Japanese contribute is that the Japanese Environment Ministry buy from us and they provide the vehicles to Angkor Wat.
Cambodia and a few countries receive a lot of aid from the Japanese government. So this is part of the aid program to encourage the use of environment-friendly Cambodian vehicles. So this is part of the Japanese aid program.
Yeah.
So how many units do you have?
Planning-wise, of course, to be able to change more than 10,000 units, but in practical for this year, I'm applying with the Japanese government for 100 units, but it's not the fund has not approved. Once it approved, then we will able to ship out by then.
So, Dr. Sri, regarding the 100 electric scooters by 2020, do you think it's still achievable?
We have received a few applications, some based on Japanese technology, MEDA is processing this application, is something that we encourage, we provide some incentives. Electric vehicles, electric scooters, electric motorcycles. How many applications have we received so far? Three or four. My dad's
process.
Yeah. By slow. I mean, this is the first one. But we have received a number of other applications.
Application you mean by brand or another brand will be introduced in Malaysia markets?
I know of one particular company. Technology comes from China. So one particular Chinese brand.
So the Iklimo is the only Malaysian company.
Iklimo is the only company in Malaysia producing electric scooters. Yes, that I know. No? Yes, the only one. Yeah, motorcycles and scooters is the first one. The only company at the moment.
So is it safe to say
100,000 another 5 years? Got to work hard. Yeah.
So you're calling more manufacturer to come forward.
Yeah,
produce
more e-scooter. Yeah, we encourage. More companies to come forward and apply.
Thank you.
Okay, merci.
Ini masih student dulu, bagaimana?
Ken?
Pergi menteri ya?
Menteri,
Ken? Belum tahu jalan ya?
Tahu.
Kita ada bunyi. Menteri ya?
Rumah mana? Rumah sini?
Tidur.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, begini tu, Miti.